Hello. Today we are talking about a love story between the lady of Baghdad, Adela Khatun, and the Mamluk, Sulaiman Abu Lail. In this place, the first lady of Baghdad, the daughter of Wali Ahmed Pasha, was walking through the slave market, now Al-Maidan market, when her eyes fell on the slave Sulaiman standing among the boats, put up for sale in front of the merchants who were arguing over his price. His gaze, his strength, his muscles, his posture, his good looking attracted her. So she pulled her father's hand and said, "My father, I want this slave." His father accepted her request, and from that day, Sulaiman entered the service of the Mamluk to be trained military and scientifically to be in the service of the state. Sorry to use those terms, but it was common and ordinary back then, and it was not as shocking as it is today. Mamluks were brought from the slave markets of countries like Georgia, Caucasus, especially the town of Tiflis, which was full of boys offered for sale. It was the Ottoman Wali Hasan Pasha who created this Mamluk army, for which he made every effort to ensure that it was trained and educated in the best way. From there, his journey began in the palace of the Wali, along with other Mamluks, to be educated and trained in horseback riding, language, literature, religion, administration, and other sciences. He was successful in all fields, so that he quickly mastered the Arabic language and became the secretary of Ahmed Pasha. The Wali found himself relying on him for military campaigns. Then came his story with the lion. During the visit of Wali Adil's father in the region of Agarkuf, west of Baghdad, when a huge lion attacked the Wali, so the young Sulaiman heard with his power to repel the lion's attack and miraculously managed to control him, kill him, and carry him on his horse amid the amazement of people for his heroism. There, Adela said to her father, Ahmed Pasha, "My father, I'm going to marry him," and pointed her finger at Sulaiman. And after the father's approval, the marriage took place. She was 34 years then, and she was strict and determined to rid herself of her adversaries, including the commander of the 4th Corps, who wanted to marry her and whom she poisoned in a grand invitation to dinner in his honor. So the way of the state is opened. Sulaiman held the post of Kahir, the most important post after the Wali. Then, in 1748, he was appointed Wali of Basra, so his wife joined him there. After the death of Ahmed Pasha, Adela Khatun and her husband returned to Baghdad, where Sulaiman became the new Wali of Baghdad. After defeating the Janissaries of Baghdad, who had struck the Sarai Palace, and after crushing the riots caused by the weak Wali, who had been appointed from the Sublime Porte, Sulaiman was the first Mamluk who took power. With him began the era of Mamluks in Iraq, which lasted almost a century and ended in 1831. Sulaiman was a strong Wali. His reign experienced great stability. He roamed the night to fight thieves and bandits and vigilants who had great influence on the society of Baghdad. For his night tours to secure the city, the people of Baghdad called him Sulaiman Abu Lail, Sulaiman of Night. Security was established in his era. The country remained that way until his death in 1762. Sulaiman continued to obey his wife as if he were his own, so she had full powers. She was appointing and firing, and she became very influential during her husband's reign. She was the lady and mistress of Al-Sarai Palace. and she was able to win over the agents, the men of power, as well as the senior officers and officials, as well as the tribal chiefs, with gifts and punishment, rewards and punishments. She was hearing people's complaints and solving their problems, and through them she knew everything that was going on in the country. Suleiman remained faithful to her. He had neither mistress nor second wife nor maid, although she was sterile like her sister. He was carrying out her orders blindly. One day he even killed her sister's husband due to the competition for power. He remained faithful until his death in 1762, following an illness he suffered during one of his military campaigns. She remained influential even after her husband's death, until her death in 1768 at the age of over 50. The Danish traveler Yabhur, in his book on his trip to Baghdad in 1766, mentioned Adela Khatun and her properties that she had built. He said she had passed away a few years ago. Her properties, or what remains of it, have always been registered in the land register, and some of them have been destroyed, such as Adela Khatun Mosque, of which these two palm trees remain as testimony. There are many other mosques, Adela Khatun, as well as the court building and many caravanserais in Baghdad and outside. What I wanted to say is that love doesn't recognize classes, and sometimes overcome them and become an example to imitate. And sometimes the loyalty of the servant is stronger than the loyalty of kings. And love might rise in unpredictable places and will continue until the end of life. Thank you.